Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, and thank you for coming out this afternoon. I'd like to welcome you all and acknowledge the traditional owners of this land, the Gadigal people of the Sydney Basin, and pay respect to the Aboriginal elders, past, present, and emerging, and any Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander people who may be here today as well. So thank you for coming along to enjoy some of the music that we love playing together. I think you might have guessed that already. One of our favourite things to do, or each and every one of us, is chamber music. And I see a few faces that we saw at our trio concert last year, when we were just Vera, Andrea and I, and we just thought there was something missing. Everyone is a gem in their lives. And it's just been a ray of sunshine just coming. And it, of course, means that we can open the repertoire of what we can perform as well. So you just heard the string quartet in B flat by Haydn. It comes from really his golden period of string quartets. We've got just 76. So Haydn, quite rightfully known amongst musicians as the father of the string quartet. Probably the most important Western classical chamber ensemble, the most versatile, still used everywhere today. And Haydn was one of the first instrumental in developing this art form. His early string quartets are quite good, from the cellist and the violist point of view in particular, probably a little bit lacking in the conversation, but it was really over 76 that he decided to give every instrument an equal voice and a chance to argue, to cooperate, to be quite cheeky. He really had a wonderful sense of humour. Haydn, and we've loved working with his quartet together. Nicknamed the Sunrise from the opening few bars where the violin emerges from the chords of the lower strings. So on to next in our program is the Brahms first string quartet. So Brahms was a totally different character from Haydn, as you'll hear in this music. It's all there in the music for you to hear, especially chamber music. It's the ultimate music for listening to the thoughts, the ideas, and the emotions of the composers. Maybe the performers too. Brahms struggled with the weight of his predecessors, of Bach, of Beethoven and Haydn, and Mozart, of course. So he was very at pains to only publish the best music that he could come up with. So it took him a long time to publish his first string quartet, this one we're about to perform in C minor, but you can hear it's a true masterpiece. You'll hear some of the struggles that he went through written into the music. You might even see us going through it. Occasionally, we're going to do our best to come out the other side. We did this concert last week on the Upper North Shore, and it was a very, very warm Sunday. So we're already grateful for coming to Glee, for the fans, for this beautiful venue. It's our first time performing here, and we love it already. So thank you for joining us here, and please enjoy Brahms' first quartet in C minor.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
one more small one for you. That was definitely the main course. We've got a sweet little dessert for you. It's the Nocturne from Borrowin's Second String Quartet. You might recognize it.